there! So Next.js just released a new feature that allows you to revalidate static pages on demand. But what exactly does that mean? How is it different from our current solutions? And how does it work? Here's a quick demo. On my website, I have a static page where I keep tweets that resonate with me. Using getStaticProps and GitHub's API, I'm fetching a list of tweets I have stored in a GitHub project. Using the Twitter API, I'm fetching the details of each tweet. Finally, I'm passing the tweet as props to my Next.js page, where I have a React component that renders them on my site. Whenever I add a new tweet to my GitHub project, I like to update the tweets on my website. But the question is, how do I update a static page? Well, before today, in Next.js, my options were to rebuild the entire site, use the revalidate property in getStaticProps to periodically regenerate the page in the background, fetch the data on the client side after the page has loaded, or if none of these options worked, I could move away from static generation and use server-side rendering. In Next.js 12.1, the response object of an API route has a new method called revalidate. Revalidate accepts a URL path. Passing the path of my static page to this method will request a regeneration of that page. This allows us to regenerate static pages on demand. Going back to GitHub, I chose to store my tweets in GitHub projects because it shares a webhook every time a project card is updated, created, or deleted. I can configure the webhook to send the event to an API route, and then inside my API route, I can first check to ensure that the request is indeed coming from GitHub. I can then use the new revalidate method and pass the URL of my tweets page. Let's see this in action, shall we? I've seen this cool tweet I like to save. So I can create a new card with the tweet in my GitHub project. GitHub has already sent the webhook to my API route to request a revalidation for that page. If I refresh my tweets page, I can see that the list has been updated. Now, let's change the order of our tweets and refresh the page to see how fast it can regenerate the static files. Ready? Boom. Go try it out for yourself. Check out the Next.js blog and the docs for more information. Have a great day.